What's going on, guys? I am coming to you today with the top 10 Rebel ships for X-Wing. I already did my previous 20 through 11, so if you haven't already checked that out. But here we're finishing up the list with the top 10. If you haven't already seen the other one, this is pretty much my opinion. So it doesn't necessarily mean that you should agree with me. You're welcome to disagree with me. A lot of this stuff is based on my own personal preferences. It's also based on maybe nostalgia. There's some ships that may just be closer to my heart that maybe you guys don't agree with, but I'll try to give you my reasons. But I also do take into consideration how effective certain things are in the current meta, how strong certain ships are, certain ships ranked higher than maybe I would have wanted them to, and certain ships didn't rank as high as I would have wanted them to. So with that all being said, we are going to kick things off. Also, stay tuned to the end of the video because we have a contest winner to announce also. So let's move forward. In at number 10 is the A-Wing. So the A-Wing, great ship. I never really was a big fan of this ship. I've become more of a fan of it as time has gone by in the game here. But I always thought it didn't look Star Warsy enough for me. It looks too much like a normal generic sci-fi ship rather than a Star Warsy ship. But as it applies to the game, this has gotten far better over time. Rebel Aces helped it a lot. But so it does have some really good pilots out there. But there are, each new missile really helps it out too. And this is and every new EPT gives the A-Wing a lot of different functionality because it can take two EPTs. So that's really one of the biggest things about the A-Wing. And I really like to fly these guys with Snapshot, because if you're only going to have two attack, well, at least maybe you can attack twice now and take advantage of that low pilot skill, and you can kind of make that Snapshot attack pretty effective, if you put certain things on there. So like Juke, for example. So I really like the A-Wing. It's not super flashy and it's not ultra competitive, but I feel it's in a good spot and it is definitely nostalgic. It was in Return of the Jedi, so it's totally Star Wars. And when I say I didn't think it felt Star Warsy enough, this was going back in the day. Like as a kid, this wasn't one of my favorite ships, but now I've grown into it. I accept the A-Wing. I'm eagerly awaiting a look at how the Episode 8 Resistance A-Wings are going to be, or if they're even going to be called A-Wings, or if they're going to have a different name, or if we're going to have some of the same problems that we've had with X-Wings, and that how can you fix one without boosting the other? And I'm just curious how that whole thing is going to wind down. But A-Wings are really nice, especially if you've got Rebel Aces and you can put two EPTs on an A-Wing. It's really nice. Number 9, the T-70 X-Wing. So the T-70 X-Wing showed up in this game with the Force Unleashed. I'm sorry, yeah, the Force Awakens, not the Force Unleashed. Totally different stuff there. And it kind of came in with a bang. So this was a really strong ship right out of the gate. Now it's, there's definitely been some power creep, so it's not, one of the top picked ships anymore, but it's still strong and it's still way better than the regular T-65 X-Wing. And that's kind of a shame, but and it's from a certain point of view, it should be better because it's a newer model ship. Costs a little bit more too, but you've got boost natively, so you can put auto thrusters on this thing. It's got three shields, which is nice. It's not quite so easy to just outright kill, and it's also can take tech. It can take astromechs. Astromechs are always great. So you kind of look what it can take, and then it's also got so many pilots now because you had the core set, then you had the T-70 the X-Wing expansion. Then you had Heroes of the Resistance. So you've got so many pilots to choose from. You got two different Poe Damerons. You've got Snap Wexley, Jess Pava. You've got all the silly ones like Red Ace and all these silly ones. But you've got a lot of pilots to choose from with this ship. It is the Ralph McQuarrie art. So if you're a big fan of like the vintage Star Wars stuff, this ship might have appealed to you quite a bit from that aspect. And it was also the first ship to bring in the Talon roll, which was pretty cool. So it's a fairly maneuverable ship too. I'm I like the T-70 X-Wing for those reasons, also because tech is not really, there's not that many stuff. It's still a newer slot, but also astromechs, always great. And it just completely kind of trumps the regular X-Wing. That part makes me sad a little bit, but it is a really solid ship. So that is the T-70 X-Wing. Moving on to number 8, the B-Wing. So some of you are like, B-Wings are terrible in this game. Why is a B-Wing in your top 10? And that's simply put, as it applies to Star Wars itself, the B-Wing is my favorite ship. It's always been my favorite ship. It's one of the coolest looking ships. It looks almost like a sword upside down. It's magnificently looking. Actually, it kind of looks like a bastard sword. But I love the B-Wing. Now, as it applies to X-Wing, it's not as strong as it ought to be. It's like it should be kind of one of the top tier fighters, is considering the timeline of when we first see the B-Wing, and even what we know from Star Wars Rebels, and that it was a prototype of the early Rebellion. So it should be way better than it is, and the hope for it is that it has a potential to take some really good upgrade slots, and so every time new upgrade slots come out, it can potentially help out the B-Wing. So, what upgrades do we have in here? Well, we have a cannon. Now, the problem with putting a cannon on the B-Wing, a B-Wing's already a moderately expensive ship. So, if you put something like one of the, a Mangler or a heavy laser cannon, you're already increasing the cost of the B-Wing. That's not a cheap ship. If you want to put a lot of upgrades on ships, it helps if they're a really cheap ship so you can kind of keep your list balanced. But you putting cannons on here, now you're approaching 30 points for a ship that's still just not that good, only one agility. And it gets criticized because of the dial isn't that good, although I'm a big fan of the 2K turn that it has. But it has a lot of red on the dial, so that's difficult to use. Personally, I really like Kian Farlander, who came in Rebel Aces with this, because he doesn't mind the red maneuvers as much, because him getting a stress is almost like him getting a focus. So there's definitely hope for the B-Wing, and a lot of that may, be related to exploiting the red maneuvers that they have. If there's maybe a system that's, going to turn red maneuvers green or something like that, that would, really, really help the B-Wing out. But also, you've got the system slot, which is, there's not a whole lot of, I mean, there's a decent number of systems, but anytime a new system comes out that can help the B-Wing, you can, if you have Rebel Aces, you can put a crew on the B-Wing, and, crew, as we know, always helps out. So there's a lot of ways you can outfit the B-Wing. It's just, every time you do that, you're making it more and more and more expensive. And at a certain point, you're going to be approaching like 35 points with a B-Wing, and you're not really getting a ship that's worth 35 points. You end up getting like a ship that's, matched, maybe by another ship that's only 25. So that's the problems with the B-Wing, but I love it, and I love the potential for this ship. I like taking it slow. I like the fact that it's got a lot of hull and doesn't really care about blocking other hits. I'm like, you know what? I can take all those crits. I've got five shields on this small ship, no problem. And this also was one of the first ships to really have that many shields, or one of the first small ships to have that many shields. Nowadays we see, really, really tanky small ships, and it has something to do with the power creep. But this was one of the first ones that really impressed me with the game. And I used to run, all B-Wing lists. I used to run, three B-Wing with upgrades, or four B-Wings and a Z95. I used to try and run that. I've always really, really enjoyed playing the B-Wing, and I had to put it in my top 10, but I knew I couldn't put it that high because of, it's lacking in the competitive scene right now. Hoping that it gets improved, though. Definitely, definitely. So that is the B-Wing at number 8. Number 7, Sabine's TIE. So Sabine's TIE is a very interesting, an interesting ship. I don't fly this one a whole lot, because it's just a regular TIE fighter, right? But it's what makes this one different. First off, you can't swarm with it because all the pilots are unique. Now, another thing about it, though, is that you are able to outfit this thing in so many different ways to really make it interesting. So You can put crew in this thing. You can make it to where it's a support ship and the enemy can't shoot at you, which is all kinds of interesting. You can also, this opens the door for being able to, steal rebel or imperial ships rather. So if you ever wanted to get like the shuttle Tidarium, this was the ship that kind of said, hey, look, the rebels can steal stuff and now we can have the same ship across factions. And all that really means is that we've got to put some potential, restrictions on there. So you can't just swarm it. Although in theory you could potentially run four TIE fighters, but you've already got the Z95, so you don't really need a TIE swarm anyway for the rebellion. But this paint job also too. The model, granted, it was the same model, but it has such a really cool paint job. It's worth pointing out that it just looks great and it's iconic. Yes, so big fan of all the different play mechanics that this kind of introduced, the whole behind the scenes. And also, and it does allow for a lot of different configurations. It also gave us the illicit, and being able to use illicit on the rebel side is a lot of fun because normally, you can't really do that sort of thing. So that much is pretty fun. The other thing that's pretty nice about it is that you're getting Sabine again, and this kind of started the whole oh, Sabine's gonna get this and Sabine's this, and so there's like X-Wing memes out there, because we've seen Sabine in so many different ships now that like, well, it's gonna be Sabine's fire spray and Sabine's YT-1300 and and then Sabine's TIE Defender and Sabine's aggressor, etc. So there were a lot of X-Wing memes about this, so it started all of that. Very agile ship, gives you the ability to outfit a TIE like you never could before, so it's fun in those regards. It also brought you Captain Rex, so brought and it brought you Ahsoka too. So if you're a big Ahsoka fan, it's nice to finally see Ahsoka in this game. A lot of cool things about this ship. Great paint job, fun to fly. Just changes up the game a little bit, and like the ship, the Sabine's TIE is your number seven or my number seven. Coming in at number six, the YT-1300. So the YT-1300 for a long time was like the top ship in the game for I would say ye a couple of years. Han Shoots First was one of the really, really strong lists, a lot, for a long time. It's still a good list, and at least a moderate level list. You can show up with this and X-Wings, or this and a couple of Z95s too, and it's and do great. But yeah, the first off, this is the ship that got me into X-Wing. This is the ship that made me fall in love with this game. When I saw this model, I said, I have to have that. And if there's a game I can play with it also, then that's even bonus. but so strong, and almost too strong when it first came out, because the game was about flying and arc dodging, and here's a ship that just could, that had, could ignore its arc and didn't care, and it flies great too. Between the hard ones and the being able to go really fast, and when you boost with a a large ship too, and you can just, you have so much mobility and you don't have to line up your arcs. Although now there's different versions of this that do reward you for lining up your arcs. So it's gotten even better with Heroes of the Resistance, because if you want to run Rey with the other version, and I'm not separating the two YT-1300s just because the dish is a little different on one, it's still the same ship. So I'm lumping all the YT-1300s together at number six. But beautiful ship, one of the best sculpts I've seen in the game, and fantastic sculpt. Great ship, great pilots. Incredibly iconic, still strong. It's stayed strong for a long time. One of the only things that hurts it is the fact that it's a large ship. So when you do lose half of your hit points, basically, then your opponent gets half points for your ship, and that's kind of why the small ships with a ton of hull and shields tends to be a little bit more competitive of a choice. But screw that. This is a fun ship. It's also a great ship for beginners too, because you're not punished for not lining up a shot. So that's If you got kids or young ones that you want to teach the game to, or just newcomers to gaming in general, this is a great ship to have them start out with. So that's the YT-1300. Next up, the Skurg. The Skurg is actually a scum ship, but it does have a rebel pilot, so I am including it on this list since you can take a rebel Skurg. This ship is just incredible. So we've been talking about power creep and everything. Yes, you got five hull and five shields on here, and you get full credit, like as long as they don't blow it up. So even if they get you down to one hull, they don't get any points off of it. So competitively, this ship is bonkers. So what else does this have? Well, you can put a turret on this ship. I mean, it's already a three attack die ship, so you don't even necessarily need that extra firepower, but you can do that, especially if you want to configure it as a bomber. This ship is revolutionized the bombing game. Everything that comes with this ship too, but the pilot abilities themselves, Nim allows you to keep the Rebel Nim allows you to keep bombs from activating, so you really stack up on the bombs and you can really manipulate the battlefield with this ship. Very cool stuff. One of the only reasons it's not higher is the fact that there's only one pilot for it, for if you're playing Rebels, because all the other four pilots are all scum. So you've only got one option, and that's Nim. So that kind of hurts it a little bit, but it's so much fun, and it can be flown multiple different ways. It can be flown just as a tank, it can be flown as a bomber, turret ship. You can put crew on there. You can put salvaged astromechs if they're unique. You can bring those in onto it. So you can it introduces a ton of different stuff, and ways that you can outfit it. So very fun ship. Its really only downfall is that it's you've only got one pilot for the Rebellion. So that's the Skurg H6 bomber. Next, the K-Wing. Some people really I think this is a ship you either love it or you hate it. And I wasn't super crazy about the ship, but first off, the sculpt, it's a really detailed sculpt, and that's one of the things people tend to hate or love. I think it's a beautiful sculpt. It looks very much like an airplane or a very World War II, bomber or something like that. It very much has that look to it. some people absolutely hate it that it looks so much like a normal airplane. But I'm fine with it. I appreciate the amount of detail that's there, and it's just huge, and it's pretty glorious looking on the battlefield to me. But I can understand why some people might not like it, because maybe they just don't think it looks Star Warsy enough, or they think it looks too busy, or something like that. So, regardless of how you feel about it, this is another ship kind of like, kind of like the H6 bomber that can be flown multiple different ways. You can outfit this thing with a ton of different ordnance. You can outfit this thing at, you can do you fly it like a turret ship. You can slam with this thing, and of course you can outfit this as a bomber. And since the release of the H6, it is really brought up the bombing game and has made bombing a really interesting, there's so many, you have so many more options playing with bombers now that you never had before. And this ship is fits into that. That's so well. Miranda too is a really sustainable ship, because here's a ship that's got nine hull and it's a small ship, so again you're not losing any points. And then now your top pilot Miranda Doni is able to recover shields. She has that built in, so that much is really fun as well. So really cool ship. It has a natural primary weapon turret. You can upload it with ordnance. You can make it a bomber. It's already tanky. It's just it checks so many blocks, and it's got slam. So yeah, it's it can go. It's mobile. It's got so many good things going for it. I wonder if if it had a different sculpt, if some of the people who don't like the K-Wing would have felt better about it. And the only bad thing I can say about it right now is that it's been hard to get in stock because they kind of sold out everywhere, and a lot of people had a very hard time getting a hold of these. But that's not really the ship's fault. That's actually more of an indication that the ship was so good. So that's the K-Wing at number four. And number three, the Ozzatuck, or your Wookiees, right? Now, this ship, the only thing I'm not particularly crazy about the sculpt on this ship. I don't have a I mean, I don't dislike it, I don't hate it. I'm just, it's one of the more unremarkable sculpts to me. It's more just in the middle of the road. And that's one of the things that I kind of, and you may disagree, but that's one of the things that influences me on, because I play this game because it's a miniatures game, right? So the better something looks, the happier it makes me feel. And that's certainly a factor based on what I want to build to fly. I'm not always going to worlds to try to, just pick the absolute mathematical best stuff. Sometimes I just pick stuff because I want to have a good time, and things that look really great help me to have a good time. So this one is ranks a little lower there, but boy, it has some cool functionality. So we've got some different pilots here. You've got another, again, a very, very tanky ship, and this is something you're starting to see. Like a lot of your top ships are very, very tanky, because, and that's kind of part of like the power creep of this game is this, you just can't have a two-hull ship anymore, or like TIE fighter, I don't know. You can't like TIE. It's one of the reasons TIE interceptors are so bad right now. It's just because, for that many points and for only three attack dice, ships are now showing up with triple the survivability of those things. You also have a full 180 degree firing arc on this ship, which makes it very easy to line up shots. You don't have the ability to turn around. Not an easy way to turn around, but that's mitigated by the fact that you've got a 180 degree firing arc. You've also got your reinforce action here, and this is a really the first small ship. You're starting to see a lot of epic style things that are kind of transcending down to the regular game, and this is another instance of that. So that's cool, and it works pretty well. And there's pilots that synergize with it, where you can spend your reinforce token to help somebody else out. This expansion actually helped out Biggs a lot with a lot of the things that it had, but some of these pilot abilities are really good for helping helping your other ships. So maybe somebody else, even if you're not using Biggs, maybe you're using Corrin Horn. Right, and somebody else wants to go after Corrin Horn, and now you can just kind of help keep other people alive, kind of spread out the damage a little bit. And in a timed game or in a tournament round or whatever, spreading out the damage is good because if they don't kill your small ships, they don't get any points. And if they leave all of your small ships with one health left on them, then you are going to do much better for that. One of the only problems that this ship has is it doesn't have a target lock, and it can kind of lack in the offensive department. But with three attack dice and pretty good support and defense, it's kind of forgiven for that. And you have things like the Wookiee Commandos that you can put on there for only 1 point. I do like that option. But it's got your two crew, so you got plenty of options for crew there. But it's just good. The pilots are good. It's a good support. Moderate attack, and helped out by that extra wide arc. Great defensive ship. It has a lot of things going for it, and it's really empowering your fleet. So it's got the support that a lot of the other ships don't have. So it's very well rounded and has extra support. So I do like what the ship does, even though I'm not that big a fan of the sculpt. And also, a lot of people like Wookiees, and they're happy to see Wookiees in the game too. More Wookiees are always cool, right? All right, so that's the Azatuk gunship. I'm getting into the top two now. Number two is the Ark 170. Now, I know that some of you hate Clone Wars era stuff. Some of you hate the prequels with a passion. I understand that. And so some people were not pleased with the inclusion of Clone Wars era stuff. I have to think and say, well, we've got all the. All the fighters from the original movies, and we're already got a lot of EU stuff, so I'm okay with at this point. I would have had a problem if this was in like the first three waves, but now this far into the game, this came out much, much later, and I'm fine with it. As a matter of fact, at this point, I wouldn't be fine. I wouldn't have a problem if they wanted to include all kinds of extra prequel era stuff. My only problem with this, and probably one of the reasons it's not number one, is because it's so good while other ships that are way newer than this aren't good. So thematics are my problem with this ship. My problem, and it's funny, I'm like, here's my top two. Let me tell you everything I don't like about it, right? Because I'm going to go on and tell you all kinds of good stuff. But yes, like the B-wing and the X-wing should be way better than this ship, but they're not. That's and I guess you justify the thematics by the title for Alliance Overhaul, like, right? Like it's an old car, but it's been fixed up, and that's fine. I suppose I'm willing to accept that, but it still bugs me. Okay, but that's it. You know, that's it. Thematics are my only problem with this ship. Now let's look at the ship itself. Auxiliary firing arc. Very cool. This was we got to see with this wave when this came out. We got to see ships shoot out the rear, but small ships, so they actually had to redesign the base. What this actually ends up doing is it ends up being extremely powerful, giving you so much to shoot at. So that much is really nice. The title allows you to take advantage of your rear shot or to also take advantage of your front shot. So it rewards good flying, which is always a plus because that's kind of what X-Wing is about. Definitely rewards good flying. This is a ship you cannot swarm, so it's got all named pilots, but they all do cool things. Whether you wanted to run this as a stress bot and in giving out stress like crazy, you can do that. Or if you just want to make this a primary attack ship, you can do that. Like it's deceptive because it looks like you've only got two attack dice, but you can get so many more attack dice. And there's been some combinations, people flying Nora Wexley in this, for example, that have managed to get like obscene amounts of attack dice when firing out of the primary arc of this ship. So it definitely rewards good flying, which is good. You can get a lot more attack dice. I mean, four is reasonable, but you can even get more than that if you really want to try to, you know, to find like the perfect storm. But generally, you know, you generally you're not building a gimmicky list just like I want to see if I can get nine attack dice. You know, yeah, that might work, but it's not, you know, it's going to be too hard, you know, to make it work. And if something goes wrong, and you're going to be really disappointed because you almost had it. But that, you know, that's something else you can do with it. But you know, here the other thing about this, all right, it's got really good, really, really nice combinations of things that you can put because you can put crew on here and you can put the astromech. Very cool astromech and crew working together here is very, very useful. Really nice. And also another cool thing about this ship is that the four pilots that came from it were all from different you know, different canon books, or I think one was from a short story. But you know, so it was nice to see, you know, your Shara Bae, who was, you know, Poe Dameron's mom, and nice to see Nora Wexley from the Aftermath books, and Thane Kyrell, for example, from the Lost Stars book, and I think it was Braylon Stram that was just from like a short story that I hadn't actually read. That was the only pilot I wasn't familiar with. But I do read a lot of the books, and so seeing all these pilots that I have read their stories and grown familiar with them was an extra nice touch for me. So, what was the thing that made this stand out about all the other ships in the list to also put it up to number two? Aside of just being solid, and aside of just also being tanky, again, you got another 9 hit point ship here, like we were talking about. And with Astromech, by the way, it can regenerate some of that. You know, like Miranda, how I talked about with the K-Wing, the Miranda could regenerate. All of these pilots can potentially regenerate because there's a couple of Astromechs that'll help you regen. So when you add in a tanky ship and you add regen to that, crazy. But the thing that really, the straw that breaks the camel's back here, the thing that really, really makes me like this ship is the sculpt. I think this is probably the best small ship sculpt in the game. And it's definitely one of the best sculpts ever. All right, I love the Millennium Falcon, the YT-1300's great, great sculpt. I do. But this one's just gorgeous in a different kind of way, right? It's a different kind of love when you look at this thing and see how beautiful. They did this one perfectly. So my hat's off to the sculpt. Really adds to the aesthetics, and it's a great ship to fly. So that is number two, the Arc 170. And we're gonna go to my number one now, and the number one, if you haven't guessed already, the VCX 100, the ghost itself, ladies and gentlemen. This is the biggest ship you're going to see outside of an Epic game. This thing is so big, they had to come out with a special stand for it. The ghost is amazing. First off, You might not fully appreciate the ship if you don't watch Star Wars Rebels. I know some people don't, but a lot of you do. I didn't expect Rebels to be that good of a show. I was just watching it because, all right, I'll try it because it's Star Wars. And by the end of the first season, I was like, this is the best show ever. And it has kind of held true to that. I'm absolutely in love with Star Wars Rebels. And I'm really sad that the fourth season is going to end it all, but I know there's going to be more stuff coming. All right. So this already has points for being from Star Wars Rebels. It's got all the characters you know and love, right? At least up until the point that this came out. But love it, love it, love it. Gives you docking capability. Now, the shuttle itself, I ranked that one in my last video. It's not so good just, I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not so good just to fly the shuttle, but you can put the shuttle docked on the Ghost. That makes the Ghost even better. All right. It's got four attack dice. Four attack dice. Big fan of that. Love that. And you can shoot out of the rear with it when you've got a docked Ghost. So, four attack dice, you can shoot front and rear with it. Incredibly strong. Incredibly tanky. 16 hit points on this thing between 10 hull and 6 shields. Very, very, very tough that way. You got two crew you can put on this thing. You got the system upgrade, which is kind of rare. Not a whole lot of ships have system. You can put a turret on here, and you might think you don't need it, but the turret gets even better with the Ghost and Phantom working together, the original Phantom title that is, and that's just amazing. You've got all, you've got pilots, you've got Hera, you've got Kanan. Kanan's actually a really, really good pilot, with his focus, or where he can spend focus tokens to make somebody roll one less die when attacking. That's really, really strong. And it's just a monstrous ship, and you can fit two of these in a list. So that is cool. You can't do three, because that would be kind of broken. But you can fit two of these in a list if you wanna. If you don't wanna dock a Phantom on there, you can still put a torpedo on there and be able to fire that out the rear because it's a special. It's not just a regular auxiliary arc. It's a special firing arc. So you can shoot your torpedoes out the rear if you want, and that's I mean that's unique. I'm not super crazy about that, but it's nice having the option. The options are always good. So I do really like, and it's got a pretty good dial too. This thing can go really fast, considering it's already a big ship. This thing can go really, really fast. So I do like, it's got the 5K turn. But it can also do a one forward, so it can go fast or slow. No agility, so it's going to take a lot of damage. But with one agility, the difference between one and no zero and one agility a lot of times is negligible. Because you were going to get hit anyway. But it's got the hull to make up for that. It's beautiful. I just and it's got the pilots that I love. It's got the thematics that I love, and it's huge. And one of the things I really, really love is big, big minis. That's why I like to play Epic. It's just not easy to play, but it's one of the reasons I play Armada too, because you have the Star Destroyers, and your games just look beautiful with these giant minis contrasted by the small minis around them. So it's my number one ship, the VCX 100. So I also want to go ahead and announce a winner here, and the winner of the second Cool Stuff gift card is P. Beckus. P. Beckus, go ahead and contact me on here on YouTube so I can get your contact details, and you just won a $20 gift card to Cool Stuff for, so you can get an expansion of your choice. That has been my top 10 Rebels ships, guys. Let me know what you agree with, what do you disagree with. And stay tuned. Make sure you are subscribed. Any future contests I have, the only thing you need to do to enter to win those is be a subscriber and leave a comment on this or one other of my videos. And that's all you need to do. So make sure you are subscribed. Click the bell for alerts so you can find out when new stuff comes out, especially when I start breaking down the scum ships and the Imperial ships as well. So stay tuned for that, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.